some sort of back plate to them, maybe. So you sort of, you know, you manufacture your spikes and like shove them through, like, I don't know, a sheet of metal or something, and then nail that up to a wall. Could have been quite interesting, that. Tell you what we'll do. Let's just torches on here so we can actually see what we're doing. Yeah. Oh, damn, son. Oh. Side. Okay, so at least we can still see a little bit. That's all clear. Quarter past 10, and this is technically not safe. Not safe in the slightest, mate. Let's keep that bubbling up. We'll keep the iron going for the rebar. Get some more rebar frames. Let's make another 100 of those. Or I just do a Daphne. I can hear it. Oh my god, I thought I saw a face in that then. Oh, freaking hell. That was spooky, mate. Let's get some food. We'll have to change Mojo's intro to the bucket song. You're right, Derp. You're right, that's... Who's Derp? Oh, there you are, Derp. I was trying to find your name in chat, Derp Squad. Sorry, mate. Let's drink. Right, yeah. Let's just clean up the inventory. Put the cotton away. Put that away. Put the potatoes away.
Hello?
This row will be all stuff we want. This row will be all actual resources as such. Throw the torch in. You're right, dog. Thank you very much for the follow, mate. How you doing, dude? Okay. Sand. I'm actually just going to... That little bit of sand we've got, I'm just going to manufacture that because it's, like, really slow, isn't it? So at least we've got it. Right, so we're going to want to chop wood in a minute. I'm probably not the whole forest down. We've got a reasonable amount of concrete sitting here. So we want to make sure we've got concrete production maxed out. What we could do of an evening is just mine once this starts getting low. Right now it's not an issue though, is it? We've probably got a good chunk of cement. Oh, we've got. Is that not doing anything? Cement did. That one. Got more cement in it. Back. Oh shit, wrong one. The reason I'm making the concrete deep here is because I'm gonna recess stuff in it. So rather than having like this big central crafting area, the central area of the pyramid is probably gonna be fairly empty. Maybe with something, I don't know, an elevator in it, I was thinking. Not sure yet. That'd be like the way in. And we'd close this up eventually, so there's no door. Because at the moment, the zombies are going to go straight for the door. So I'd clear all this out and actually have everything countersunk in one block, which is why I'm doing the rebar around here. So, you know, we're not going to suddenly end up with a really weak first layer wall. By the way, does my voice sound really different today? It feels like, I don't know, it feels like I'm underwater to me. It's like, oh god, it's so croaky, mate. Not breathing in deeply. Let's get rid of this bloody spike, because that's just going to end in disaster, isn't it? What's the gauge and the light bulb for? Well, the bulb is to make, because we can make our own lights. We've actually got a mod that enables us to craft the zombie generators. And... diesel generators. Ah, is that actually right? Nope, no, it is right. Oh god, I thought I made a fuck up then. So that'll go there. Oh, I haven't fucked this up, have I? Do we need that command now? He's already fucked it. It was out 3, right? Yes. Yes, it was. Jesus, I really started doubting myself then. All right, let's pop another torch up here. There we go. Brilliant. And the gauge is for the distillery, which is actually what I jumped on today to start doing. And then I suddenly got... You know what I'm like, mate. I thought we'd have a little bit of a tinker with a sort of pyramid-esque out here in the desert. And now look at us, like an hour and 17 minutes later. I actually don't think the distillery makes anything. I think it's one of those modded assets that you can place in-game that you actually just use to come up with your own recipes, so... I tell you what, I've not been so excited for like a patch in a game. Normally
Grum,
patches in games.
Stay on track. Your O shiny syndrome is acting up again.
It's not. It's. I'm focused, Sky. I'm focused. Actually, we're out of wood. Let's go and get some woody. I forgot what I was saying there. Oh yeah, normally like patches and things for games. I'm trying, Sky. I'm trying, mate. Yeah, patches come and go, and I very rarely give much of a flying toss about them. It's very, very rare you get like a big patch for a game these days that actually really means anything. Obviously, if it's bug fixes and things like that, that's great. You know, I mean, for example, I own the full super duper season pass for The Division. And I've just not been back. Even though I actually spent all that bloody money, I've still not been back and played that game, even, you know, despite the fact there's been loads of new content and everything added. But Alpha 15, really, honestly, it genuinely excites me. I've not felt like that about a game for so, so long. It's a really nice feeling to have. It is. I mean, I don't know if any of you, like, you know, presumably most of you play games a lot. You know, most Twitch viewers fall into one or two categories, I find. Have given up on gaming themselves and like to watch other people playing them. Or still play themselves while they're watching somebody else stream it. And it seems to be pretty much 50-50 a lot of the time when we sort of ask that question. But I know a lot of folks, in particular on the forums that I frequent, where they, you know, people kind of say, look, I've just lost interest in gaming. I've got all these games, I turn the computer on, I go to play something, but you know what? I end up just flicking on Twitch instead. And I don't think I've ever had that too badly, you know, that desire to say, look, I just don't fancy playing a game for a while. And people always say, like, if you do feel like that, you should probably just take a break, just don't turn it on. But I think with this game, it's really, I don't know, it's like invigorated my desire to keep playing sort of PC games. Because I was starting to feel like I was going to flitter back towards a bit of console stuff at one point. Go back and play some of the PlayStation 3 stuff that's been remastered. Like the David Cage games, Beyond Two Souls. What's the one with the origami dude? Heavy Rain. You know, sort of go back to those kind of things. But I have to say, it's the one thing that keeps PC gaming interesting, isn't it? Is that the modding scene and the fact that patches and stuff tend to come out reasonably frequently. I think that's the big difference between consoles and PC. It's that level of customization it kind of offers you. But I still like the console exclusives massively. Yeah, because I think both those games that I've just mentioned have re-released recently on PlayStation 4, haven't they? I did really like Heavy Rain. Fantastic game. Beyond Two Souls was a really good game, but I think of the two, Heavy Rain was the one that kind of caught my attention more. It was quite a dark theme as well, wasn't it? Well, a very dark theme. What's that? Don't tell Simps you should have you off on a week long. What's that? Oh dear, sorry about that. Okay. All right, so that row, is that the whole perimeter done? I feel like I've not done something. Have I not missed a layer of rebar somewhere? No, all looks good. Yeah, I'm much more comfortable doing this than not doing it. I think it's important we build it layer by layer. What's that area? It's D19. I got to say about 200 and searched everything I could on the map a couple of times and never found one. Oh, you're talking about 76 and the... Is it calipers or something?
Hello?
Where can I see the Alpha 15 patch notes? There aren't any, because Alpha 15's not out, mate. There are no patch notes. You're right, Hitchbots. Oh, I still think Alpha 15, we're looking... I actually keep... I mean, I originally thought, like, maybe the first 1 to 2 weeks of August, if you remember. And then I changed that to, like, the middle to back end of August. I'm starting to feel, at the moment, the weight and the rate with which old Moly Moly's releasing new information. I'm starting to think we might be looking at, sort of, September at the moment. It's like every week something new. I mean, fucking lockpicking? Seriously? I didn't know they were even working on lockpicking. I certainly didn't realise they were working on lockpicking to the degree that they are working on it. I thought, you know, if they do add lockpicking, it'll just be like a little... I certainly wasn't expecting a Skyrim-esque minigame and possibly a lockpicking skill as well. That was absolutely fantastic. I'm not a big fan of those kind of... click when it's in the right area mini games, but I think it'd be pretty cool. It's Mario! We can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, places they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world. Oh, I've already done them, mate. They're here, look. What did you mean by that, King Daddy Dean? You meant these? I've not gone wrong, have I? Everything looks right. Going up one layer internally each time.
Hello?
Bloody cactus. You're right. Pear. It's P Ridge, you see? If I look at the... So there's no differentiation between Cap's characters or not on my one preview. Sorry, P. I did call you Pear there, mate. Sabina! The internet's back on. Break the mold. Hey now, you're an all-star. How you doing, Advina? How's it all going, mate? Have you managed to get your Virgin Media friends to plug you back in, have you? You are... Advina, you are a Pokemon addict, mate. I can imagine you sitting there with your phone, right? When you're posting up those pictures in Discord, cackling like a mad woman. Oh, God, did you hear my throat there? Oh, my God, what the... Oh, Jesus Christ, I hope you didn't hear that. Fucking hell. Oh, Jesus, that was frightening. I'm glad I've got a headset on. Yeah. Okay, bish, bash, bosh. So we'll just keep going up one layer at a time. Yep, all done. Okay. Did you hear that? Good. Oh my God, I hope you didn't. Did you really? Oh, I'm so sorry, folks. It better not be a fucking death rattle, mate. Fucking hell, that was unpleasant to say the least. I'm so sorry. So you're back on just temporarily, you reckon, Advin? Because they said they weren't coming until Monday to fix it, didn't they? I suppose it's lovely in weather like this, though, Advina. You know, you can take a little one out, can't you? Have a little stroll. I'm sure Pokemon Go will... they were all saying, weren't they? It would sort of, like, tail off here in winter time. But I think it's just picking up more and more traction. I think as the servers settle down and all the rest of it, I still think people will be playing it no matter what. Isn't there some kind of, what was that site you were talking about? Or someone was talking about, might not have been you, about you can find out where the Pokemon are without, is it some sort of like app that kind of cheats the location of certain types of Pokemon? I don't really understand. I didn't really understand lures, to be honest, until recently either, but I think I've got that all figured out. Well, let's start off. Actually, you know what? Let's just knock out. I know it's going to be boring as fuck, guys, but I've got to get rid of one side of this. Otherwise, it's going to start giving false support. Oh, Jesus. I think what I'll do in a minute, folks, I'll do a couple of spins if you're up for that, Fortune, and I'm just going to go and stick my head over a bowl of hot water with some menthol things in it just for a couple of minutes, if that's all right. I don't think raspy rattles is a good thing for anyone, is it? What's that, Mr. Kitten Slat? Is this crazy? No, mate. No, not at all. It's all legit. It's on and off. I suppose that's even more upsetting, Advina, because, you know, it's probably just like... Like, was it Doku was saying? It's probably just like one little bloody cable that's come slightly loose somewhere in one of the comms distribution boxes or something. You got any of those green boxes down your road, Advina? Go and give them a jolly good bang as you go past them. Advice on someone with defective lungs. Breathe out slowly. And deeply breathe in a little and fast with it. It empties your lungs of part of the stuff in them for a bit. So what do? You breathe out slowly and you deeply breathe in little and fast. It's like... Right, until your lungs are full. So like you basically just breathe in like little raspy quick bursts. I was told I needed to breathe really, really deeply. I suppose that's what you're actually saying, Sky. As regularly as I could. Apparently, a lot of the issues can be with stuff like down in the base of your lungs, where you know you don't typically breathe heavily. But it's like I was saying, I do that a lot because I do a lot of running. So my lungs are, you know, every single day, I'm you know, they're at capacity in that sense. It's not like I lead a very lethargic life, so I'm not, you know, really breathing in super deeply. So I'm kind of used to doing that anyway, but only when I run. So of course I'm not doing that at the minute, or if I'm biking. Apparently if you're quite sedentary, you don't very often replace the air that's like really deep in the, like, is it the alveoli in the lungs? So every now and again, you should breathe in really, really deeply, as deep as you can, just to refresh that air that's down there, that's sitting there sort of stagnant-y. You've got to breathe out long. Okay. I'll try that when I'm out there, Sky. That was it, Ares. Yeah, I'd actually mentioned that earlier, mate. That's the whole point. We're going to countersink everything into the wall, so all this will go. Because it's obviously a bit of a blot at the moment. Oh, actually, I do like this now. I think I've changed my mind on that. And I think the beauty of it is because you'll be coming at it from a distance rather than, you know, really close, because this will all be gone. That whole central area will be gone. So, like, for example, we might have a forge built into the wall here and then another forge here, maybe with some chests in between or what have you. So those are gone, which is good, because we, like I said, we don't want any false support, do we? Now, I think we should also, for purposes of not making a boo-boo, get rid of this sand. Because again, it's on a different level, isn't it? Breathe out deeply. Yeah, I've got this guy, I've got him. That's sort of the opposite of what I was told, but I will do yours. I'll breathe out. So I'd like really expel all that air out. Get rid of it all. I'll do it, Sky. I'll come back and I'll tell you. If I don't make it back, mate, it's because you've killed me, alright? Yeah, it's not too bad, Errors. I really didn't like it before, but I think that's because it looked, because it still looked wet as such. Do you have like really bad asthma? Is it then, Sky? I know you've mentioned that before. I mean, is it like really chronic asthma? Yeah, are you one of these people that like is in serious fucking danger if you're if you have an asthma attack and you know you've not got your inhalers with you? I don't know if you've been around when I've mentioned it before, Sky, but my girlfriend has pretty bad asthma. You would never know it, you know. She doesn't like typically struggle to breathe regularly, and I always thought, you know, she quite often uses her inhalers and things, and she's super active as well. So, yeah, she's running or roller skating and all this sort of stuff. You just wouldn't know it, but I always thought she took the piss. I thought she was like, you know, I know it's a horrible thing to say, but I always thought she was a bit of a hypochondriac about it, and. You know, I thought, like, do you really need to take these inhalers, like, everywhere you go? And it's like, well, yeah, well, you know, I do, and all the rest of it. And I never really understood. And then one day, Sky, I actually saw her have, like, a genuine proper asthma attack. And you know what? It scared the living shit out of me. I mean, she was used to it, you know. She's had them before, but it was the first time I'd ever seen her have one. And oh, my God, did I have to eat my words, mate. I just didn't realise how serious it was. It was the first time I'd ever seen anyone have an asthma attack. And it was fucking shocking, mate. Shocking. So, yeah, it was a bit of an eye-opener for me, to be fair. I think the beauty of it is most people with asthma, I suppose, I mean, if it's not, you know, like, I don't know how it works and if there's, like, tiers of it, but, you've got to assume that, these inhalers do an amazingly good job, don't they, of opening up those airways. It works for you, Grum, and you have asthma. Yeah, you rarely get an attack, but if you do get an attack, it's horrible. If you don't have your inhaler, you need to go to the hospital. Yeah, shit, man. I think she's got three different sorts of inhalers. Is it like the purple? I can never remember the bloody names of them and what's in them and everything, but I'm sure it's... look, because that might be supporting that. Look, we need to get rid of this. Is it the purple one that's the, oh fuck, shit's got real one? What's that, Strike? Make a tier 7 asthma wave. What, Grum, make a rebar internal corner. What's that for, dude?
Grum has caught a social disease. Antibiotics might help cure that itchy rash.
That the new infected command, is it, Fortune? I like it. Now, don't forget... Discord, drop me a little message. I'll add it to the Grumblepedia. You're right, Bomber. How you doing, dude?
Hello?
You were on very early this morning, mate. Or I suppose technically late for you, wasn't it? Hello, Jack. I'm just going to get rid of a little row of this because I'm really worried about it giving us full support. Oh shit, you've got CO pulmonary. Oh fuck me, Ares. Oh, that shit, dude. Oh, Ares, that's fucking awful, mate. I'm sorry to hear that. Did you had that for long, mate? Hello, Phoenix. When you place the rebar ramps, follow the pattern in the rebar. Oh, you instead of making the concrete ones. Oh, I didn't even know you could do those, mate. Hang on. Let's check that out. Oh, perfect, dude. That would be brilliant if that's what I think you're saying. I wasn't going to take it all out now, mate. I just wanted to get like rid of a couple of corner ones. I was going to take all this out when we're off stream, to be honest. So, yeah, we'll just sort of, like, knock all of these out, won't we? And then all that will just collapse. I suppose actually I've just taken out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I would have been quicker actually, wouldn't it, mate? Shit. Sorry, dude. Good tip, mate. Good tip. So you're saying I can actually make corner rebar in the forge? Is that what you're saying? Oh, dude, this might be loads easier then. Right. Good thinking, Batman. Give it a whirl. It's still going to be a fucking nightmare, isn't it? Oh my god. I have no idea what that one's actually doing there. Oh, that is easier, dude. That is easier. Oh! But I suppose... Ah, and the beauty of it is if I do it wrong, mate, I can just pick it up. So, Brucey bonus. Gone past it, haven't I think. God, how many bloody rotations has that thing got? Oh, thanks for that one, mate. That's brilliant. That's going to make my life a shit ton easier, isn't it? So what's the next layer we want to do? That's another... Oh, shit, we're out of rebar nearly already. Let's make another 100 of those at least. And I think what we'll do... How much iron? Let's stick another stash of iron in there. Split a stack of wood. Going. We're going to need it. And when I smash the forges out, any surplus iron and what have you... Oh, shit. Tell you what. Let me just grab some normal... Replace these. First aid kit. Let me just make some normal bandages. Have I not got any cloth? Really? Where's all the cloth? Oh, I know. I bet it's in here, isn't it? Bandage. Make more. Let's make 8 normal bandages. And with that cotton. Let's make, I don't know, let's make 100. That'll be alright, won't it? Let's throw the cotton back in. Pine seeds can come back in. Because we'll replant later, I'm not interested about that at the moment. That iron should not be in there. Let's throw those in there. So I've got 3 normal bandages on me. Okay, brilliant. God damn it! Idiot! That's gonna happen a lot, isn't it? Let's do the next layer. Fucking fucker. Oh god. Oh, Jesus. Oh god, we were going to make a coffee and do some spins, weren't we? Sorry guys, let me just do this one layer. I'll put the rebar down, then I promise you we'll go and do things. Anyway, Phoenix, how's the survivor so far? Adding, this is actually not really the main base, mate. This is, like I said, this is just our, well, to be honest, it's turning into a fucking monster, isn't it? It's actually nearly as big as the fort fuck it over there anyway. And that's not even the main base. The blue one's... Oh, the blue one's the panic mode one. Is it the purple's the daily? It's... I've probably got them the wrong way around then. It's like I said, I don't suffer from it, but I really did realise just how horrible it can be for someone. Got it. Does it get worse for you in the summer then, Sky? I mean, I suppose the humidity plus all the pollen, I mean, it's just a recipe for disaster, isn't it? It's a great game, Phoenix. Alpha 15's about to hit as well, Phoenix. We just don't know when. It could be like in a couple of 3 weeks. It could be in a couple of months for all we know. But it does look really cool. What's that? And do you play with subs? Well, yeah. With viewers, mate. We've got people on the server. If you want to join us, just drop into the Discord and put an app in. You be careful, Wrecker. I don't want to hear about you having any bloody accidents, mate. raging around the streets on your new supercharged bike. Right, okay. Let me just do, let's, Fortune, are you okay to do a couple of spins, mate? And then I'll get a raffle up, and then I'll take like just a very quick 2 minute break, grab myself a drink. We've been on for nearly a couple of hours now, haven't we, so. Ooh, it's looking quite nice. Hmm. Yeah, I might actually change the wooden spikes for the nasty spikes. Hmm, don't know. Have a look at that. Back up, please. I'll just get in the bunker so we know we're safe. Can zombies get in bunker bases? Yes, they can. They can dig down and cause you all sorts of untold problems. That's a different view from this morning, isn't it, when we started? Jesus, that's exactly where we started today, up here. Okay, let's have a quick look. We're going to do the raffle first, and then we'll do some spins at some point. Let's have a look. What have we got? We've got Shiplord, donated by Dolphin.
Hello?
Sorry about the clackety clack. Right, so we've got, let's have a quick look. So this is a game called Shiplord. It's been donated by Dolphin, so if you're interested in a copy of that, just grab yourself a raffle ticket. I'll do the draw as soon as I get back. You'll need to be in chat for about the next 4 to 8 minutes. If you want it, because obviously we'll pull a winner. If you're not in chat when we pull the winner, we will pull another person. So there you go. I'll be back in a jiffy, folks.
Hello?
Right, I'm back. I thought I'd try and catch you all out there. It's just too many people. Just come in chat. I've noticed recently, in fact, you mentioned it earlier, Fortune, so I didn't want to sort of make it too obvious, but a lot of people are just coming in and just doing, like, the first thing they do is just, Grum! That's it, that's all they do. You've got, oh, hang on, you'll have to tell me when the drag race is over, folks. Oh, I've got the, I've put the old kettle, I don't normally use the kettle for anything, really. But, just got the old kettle on to get a bowl of hot water. Bowl of hot water! Girlfriend uses the kettle for a tea, you see. Don't offer make her tea. I'm not a very good tea maker, apparently. All part of my cunning plan. Quite looking forward to having this up and running. It's something that's just been really niggling me. It was very un-Grum Industries like, just creating a rectangle of concrete. You're right, Daddy Dean. Oh, you're getting buffering. Fortune had that earlier as well, mate. And Fortune very rarely gets buffering. Did I not make any more curved rebar? Oh shit, I didn't. Along for this drag race, guys. You're right, unlucky. Sorry, Matt, I'm just waiting for the drag race. That's not what the stream normally looks like. How's your weekend going, unlucky? Christ, you like trying to kill my poor Grumbot? Drag races, raids, raffles, queues. It's actually quite a good test for it. Right, now I've also got these wonderful things called lockets. Apparently these are extra strong and they have menthol and eucalyptus and honey in them. R5 by the looks of it. There you go. I wonder if something's changed on Twitch's end over the last couple of days. It seems strange that you've had problems, Fortune. Sorry. I just peeled the lozenge. They're very sticky little things. What were we doing? Where did we get to? Next layer. Let's see if we can crack on with this. Come on. Thank you. Fuck, I didn't actually pick him up yet. So, Stripe. Any issues if you're still in chat, mate? You seeing any potential problems here, Sunshine? That lead architect here in Grumbodia. Record cheated off on their bike, look. Looking good. Can you make these corner pieces with a rebar as well? I mean, I don't have I don't struggle with them, so it's not an issue. I just wondered if can all of these concrete pieces be made? Oh, hang on. Well, I've not done the corner pieces. Oops, my bad. Yeah, I think it's important that we actually do this. I think it's going to look better. Not only look better, but it also enables me to actually clamber up here without touching a spike. I mean, at least for now. I think that's going to work quite well like that. You've got to be shitting me. Really? You cheeky sausage. I reckon we're okay, Strike, yeah. Done today's health and safety checks. Confident. Oh, there's a lot of pressure on your house, Strike. It's all been made official now. I've gone and said it, haven't I? Oh. Actually, Grim, when will you spin? I don't know. Who knows? You need to go to bed, Fortune. Are you tired? We'll spin when we get the next layer on. Eat in about 5 minutes, I reckon. Oh, Mojo's off for a... Bit of brekkie there by the looks of it. Okay, let's just get the next internal layer on. Oh, that's the raffle. Alright, let's have a look. So, this was for a copy of Shiplord. So we've got a few, actually there's quite a few folks in there. Alright, so I'm going to draw the winner. If your name is drawn out of the hat, please type exclamation mark claim in chat. Please do not type exclamation mark claim in chat if it's not your name, because we will ban you. It's for the winner only, that command, so please respect that. Okay, and the winner is Mario, which doesn't surprise me, actually, considering how many tickets you bought, so that's fantastic. So, quick exclamation mark claim in chat. Excellent, that's what we like to hear. Nice prompt claim. Nice one, Mario. Congratulations, dude. And that's from Dolphin. So big thank you to Dolphin, more importantly. Jump on Discord. Prizes galore for him. Let Dolphin know you've won a game, dude. GZ. Right, rebar. Rebar inner frames. Let's make, I don't know, let's just make 12 for now. Already got a couple there. Do spins now. While I make these, I'll get another raffle up then in a sec. So, we have, next up is Fortune. You're actually in first, Fortune. GZ. You right to get these, Fortune, or are you otherwise engaged? Good luck, Lady P. $75. Next up is Advina. Good luck, Advina. Hope the internet holds out while we spin for you. Cheeky little 75. Next up is Stripe. Good luck, Stripe. Oh, could be a level up. We didn't have a level up yesterday, did we? Nice one, Stripe. Level 2, mate. See you later, Advina. Oh my god, it's all the way to level 3. Fantastic, dude. I have a good feeling we might be getting a golden grum bomb here. Good luck. Stop! 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 No! 250, mate. So damn close, dude. So damn close. Oh dear. Alright, okay, let's carry on. What were we doing? What were we doing? What were we doing? Oh, is that right? That's not right, is it? See what, let's just stop. Come back.
Hello?
Just can't make it out at all. Sorry, who was that? You at Apex, how you doing, mate? Is that the one? Oh god, I hate this block so much. Oh, I just went past it!
Hello?
So many rotations! It's got so many variables. That's right. Excellent. Thank you for the follow there, Big Boy Dazza as well. How you doing, mate? It's Sunday! Chill out day. Building a pyramid. Can't be bad, can it? I really wish I could get someone to just smash this out for me. What a pain in the backside that is. Ah. Do you think that's going to count as a support? I'll tell you what, look. Rather than fucking talk about it, let's just fucking do it. Let's just smack the shit out of this. It's horrible, Spectrum. I think Stripe. Was it Stripe? Just mentioned making it out of rebar. It definitely makes it easier. And the beauty of it is if I do misplace it, I can just pick it back up. Hello, Mr. D. How are you? Daiko, did you have a chance to check out that dual universe that I spoke about yesterday? I was going to have a look myself, but I just never got around to seeing if there was any more footage out there. What have you been doing to kitties? Zweihander. We don't want to know what you're doing with your small eye, mate. I actually thought it would be nice if we could have done the grounding. Hey again. Bit late now, isn't it? That's a hell of a lot of concrete to knock out just to have a slightly better looking floor. Probably not a good idea having a hay floor with campfires and forges everywhere anyway, to be fair. You alright, Marv? Yeah, random gem, mate. Seed name is Grumbodia, if you want to. It's a very good seed, actually, mate. Very, very good seed. Make another pickaxe as well if we carry on chopping any more out. Just want to get it out of the way. It's got to happen at some point. It's only about 7 or 8 blocks, isn't it? Yep, you can, yep. Just got to have it exactly the same name, that's all. What do you want, Marv? You want Xbox or PlayStation 4 or PC? I think we've kind of come to the conclusion that if you use a PC seed on the PlayStation 4 or Xbox One, it's not the same, which kind of just really surprises me, to be honest. But maybe the random gem maps just aren't as big. There we go. Yeah, if you're on PC, just use Grumbodia. There's lots of water, there's lots of all the different biomes, there's lots of cities. We don't seem to be short on anything, mate. You see the YouTube links I gave to XP Games cover on Dual Universe? No. Sorry, mate. Yeah, have you had any more thoughts on No Man's Sky, Dyke? Are you going there or not? Or are you going to sort of like just be concentrating on Starbound for a bit? I was going to check out that ship Graystrom was telling us about yesterday for the early access. Oh, sorry, early access, for the pre-order. I didn't get a chance to do that either. Had a rather lazy evening yesterday. I was chatting away on Discord for a bit and then raced out when the taxi honked his horn, and that was it, really. I didn't get a lot done. Nice one, Kippy. 156 GBs. Nice one, dude. Right, brilliant. That at least frees up a bit of space. All of this crap's just going to have to go. What was so hard about making the biogas digester? Was it just brass? I don't think there's anything any more convoluted than that, was it? I'm so tempted to smash the shit out of everything we've got and just clear this middle area. Hungry and thirsty. Let's get food before we die. Any inventory space for my lovely poos? I think we have. Let's throw these away. Yeah, do you use it as the save name? Marv, so when you go to, you know, when you create a random gen world and you have to give it a name. Hang on. Yeah, so that's alright. I was going to curf. I am, hang on. Back. Yeah, just call the save game Grumbodia and you'll end up with exact. The exact same map as I'm on, dude. I mean, to be honest, I've not got anything to compare it to in terms of if it's like a really good seed, but we're not missing anything. Whereas a lot of folks are saying, you know, they can't find water or, you know, there's no desert biome, yada, yada, yada. I mean, we've quite comfortably found all the biomes, all in relatively close proximity to one another. In fact, until the last couple of days, I'd have said that the only thing we seem to be sure of were desert biomes, and we found two absolutely sprawling sort of biomes since then, haven't we? Which we do actually need to revisit to get some aloe at some point. Yeah, there is, isn't there, fortunes? A hell of a lot. Build from corners as we normally do. Yep. I've actually bobbed that, haven't I? I've just suddenly realised that is actually supposed to be. I'm confuddled.
Hello?
What have I done wrong there? That's not right, is it? Hello, Marv. Did I balls that up? I have, haven't I? That should not be there. Hello, Dayhawk. How you doing, mate? Oh, careful. What the fuck is going on? This bit here is supposed to be the corner piece, isn't it? That's even harder at that angle. Try not to set myself on fire. Oh shit, I just went past it. Try not to set myself on fire with the bloody furnace right behind myself as well. That looks right, doesn't it? So fucking confused right now. We'll get there, don't worry. What might take a bit of perseverance, a bit of trial and error. We will not be defeated. Still not even got the nail gun. To be honest, it don't take long to smack this up, does it? Just saw the trailer for the new Flash. I didn't even know there was a new Flash, dude. You got a link to it, Dayhawk? What natural wind is that, dude? Oh my god. Yeah, so this one's actually a layer of spikes, isn't it? So if we do the corner piece and put another two of those. God damn it, come on. Focus. All corners, let's just make another, I don't know, 12 of those. Ah, throw them in. There we go.
Grum, you bobbed another build. Grum Industries will dock your pay for lost materials.
I've bobbed it? Where have I bobbed it? I have not bobbed nothing. Bob the Builder! He can fix it! Ow! God damn it. Okay. So that one's all done there. I haven't bobbed it, have I? You're just testing things, Fortune. Geeky little tester. I think the fun part will be actually sorting out the bloody inventory downstairs because it's been niggling me for a long, long time. Let's get these corner pieces put in. I'm on fucking fire again. Oh my god, dude. Stop, drop, and roll. Roll around in the sand, dude. See? Legit fucking fire safety there, guys. Let's try and get these ones that we've still got made put in. Alright. Looks good to me. There we go. Laughing Jabbly. All under control. Nobody panic. We've got this. Oh, I'm so gonna smash the crap out of all of this stuff in a minute. I don't care what's in it. I'm just gonna smash it all. Do you think I could just get like some TNT? what would that do? If I put a block of TNT, right, in the middle of the forges, what would happen? Serious question. Oh, I can't remember. Oh, hang on. We've probably got hundreds and hundreds of bloody land claim blocks all buried around, haven't we? It's so annoying having this here. It really is. You need to go! Not sure how we're going to do it. I fancy like a little wall of chests at the back here. Maybe a little workbench buried into the wall here. No, how about like a workbench here? So hollow out four blocks, a workbench embedded, like Mojo had. And then to the left and the right, like two sets of boxes. I think the boxes countersunk in the floor with the vaults in front of it. Blech, I'm not sure. Anyone got any ideas? Oh, fucking fuck buggers. God damn, that one spike has had me a... How many times has he had me? Let's take these other bandages. So this one is spikes. So the next one is just rebar. Obviously, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make it as is. I might leave the 3x3 at the top ready to implement the flamer. Because somehow we're going to have to actually get a gas tank up here and suspended. But we'll worry about that later on. I'm not going to worry too much today about that. Yeah, the wet concrete is if you check, I mean, I suppose what we could do is we could, like, do a layer a day now. I think to this point we were okay. Right, concrete. I think it's the next two layers where I'm not entirely... Oh, God, not again. I'm not entirely convinced, Stripe. It might be worth us just letting this set now. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, this side's okay, but there's quite a lot of this is still wet. Yeah, the next horde's a tier 6, which I think is in 3 days' time, actually. How many deaths have we got? We've got 7 at the moment, which... we've got 97,000 items crafted. To be fair, I'd probably reduce that to like 5, maybe 4 or 5 legit deaths. We've had a couple of just nonsensical ones that really weren't our fault. See, the plan is at the very top is to have like a flat 3x3 area with a central piece having a flame trap in it. I really should have thought about the trunking or the piping system for it, but it's really hard, you know, because obviously it's quite slow to build something like this. Quite hard to sort of visualize where would be the best place at this point until we get it kind of a bit more fleshed out. What do you reckon, Strike? Do you reckon we can hit one more or not? The rebar weighs the same, doesn't it? So... Do we even need a support, Stripe? Serious question, mate. Do we need a support? Yeah, the wet concrete's got less structural integrity from what we seen. Yeah, it'd be nice, wouldn't it, Dean? I mean, you know, I'm still working away at that. At some point, there's no reason why not. We could actually, again, I suppose the structural integrity of those spike traps is the issue, because we'd have to almost essentially knock out part of these corner blocks to actually get the steam pipes in there. Wow, I wish it just, it'd be nice if it just decided to dry, wouldn't it? Right, let's have a think about how we're going to do. Well, I'm going to let it dry. End off. Right, decision made. Let's let it dry before we do the next layer. Let's have a little think about how we're going to do these furnaces, because then I can start knocking them out. What we'll do is we'll empty them, place them back, and just like have them fired straight back up. So has anybody got any suggestions about what we can do in terms of crafting? I definitely would like a crafting workbench in here, so I think we're going to make one of those first. And I think it would be nice to see that when we walk in, so we'll probably put it on this like western wall. Get this all concreted up. So we made it 13 by 13, didn't we? So presumably there is actually... Oh, shit. Presumably that's the central block, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's all worked out kind of nice. Let's attack the bejesus out of this. It's fucking 2x2, isn't it, that fucking thing? I'll tell you what, sod it. Fuck it. Balls to it. Let's just put a couple of... Should we just have, like... We just have three furnaces at the back here. What do you reckon? Do not touch the ramp walls for pipes. No, definitely not, Stripe. No, that's what I mean. There'd be no way to knock these out to replace them. We'd have to essentially put them on it. And I genuinely don't know what integrity, what weight, what anything those pipes have, if indeed anything, to be honest. Is wet concrete a mod? No. It's just most people probably just, like you said, make the concrete blocks and then